I get the ball and I reload it. Get my four footer and bring it on as I take hits from the bong.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Weedy Wednesday Comedy Show at Vapor Central. Are you ready to have some laughs? People, that was fucking pathetic. Are you smoking bunk weed? Who's ready for a fucking comedy show? There we go. I bumbled it out there. Please welcome to the stage your regular host. It's a dead man lookalike. It's Bryan Ogorman.
They call me Mr. Negativity. Call it how I see. Yes, I'm back in the vicinity.
Sean, everybody. The world's fattest anorexic up here for you tonight. He thinks I look like Deadmau5. I think that's nice, but I wish I did look like someone that wasn't like a fucking guy who's famous for being a computer nerd. But still, it's good to be here. Wednesday, Weedy Wednesdays. We have three amazing comedians for you guys tonight. Your headliner, Ray DeVito. He's in all the way from New York City. He's on tour right now, so he'll be here for you headlining tonight. And then we have two other professional comics that are absolutely awesome. Plus, a bunch of videos tonight. We're going to show you some video. We're going to continue our million-week series of animals getting fucked up with some drunk elephants. It's going to be dope. And then we have videos of real hover bikes. Did you guys hear about this? I know, like, you saw the video in the summer where it's like, oh, there's real hoverboards, and it was total bullshit. You're like, you lied to me again, Tony Hawk, right? But fucking, this is a real live hover bike. Boom, that's the first picture. Okay, put it away, Chris. I don't want to excite these people too much right now. Stoners, like, their fucking heads are going to blow up. That was real. It is real. And we're going to get to the bottom of it tonight. Also, we're giving away a bong like we do every single week here on Wednesday at Vapor Central. So one of you will win a bong and then forget it in the subway later tonight. It's going to be a fucking awesome show. Couple rules. If you guys are in the front or anywhere in this, just try to keep it down. Be quiet during the show while the guys run. Try not to talk, specifically the guy talking in the front, not listening. Have a good time. If your cell phones are on, turn them off or vibrate. Something like that, just so you're not disrupting the comedians, because they bite. They'll bite you. It's going to be a good time. Anyway, you cut it. School's back in. You guys in school? Anybody back for school here? Couple of people. Everyone's like, fuck yeah. Fucking here for fucking school. How many of you guys, do you guys like your teachers? You dig them? Yeah. It's important to know if your teachers aren't good at teaching, you know? Because then you're just learning from a moron, and you'll be dumber than a moron later in their life. You know what I mean? You got to be honest. Sometimes they'll teach you shit you don't need to know. Like, when I was in high school, I was really bad at math, so I would bring calculators into exams. It's fucking smart, right? Solves the problem. But my teachers would get mad. They say, Bryan, you can't just bring a calculator with you wherever you go. There's never going to be a time you can just pull a calculator out whenever you need it. That's never going to happen. Guess what I have with me wherever the fuck I go now, huh? A calculator attached to a phone, a camera, and all the knowledge in the history of the world. Yeah, fuck you, Mrs. Urbitowitz, all right? From now on, I'm only listening to Japanese dudes. Except about nuclear fusion, they suck at that. Okay. I grew up in Markham, so I make a lot of Asian jokes. I'm sorry, it's just the way I was raised. My boys are Asian. All the dudes I grew up with are all like Chinese guys, but they sound like me. Same accents, right up until the cops pulled them over, then they turned Chinese like fucking that. And they always say the same thing to confuse the cops, no matter what the question. They just say this. They just say, I don't know. That's it. That's the whole thing. That's a bulletproof fucking alibi right there, if there ever was one. You know why I pulled you over? I don't know. You have a license or registration? Ha ha, I don't know. Like, you even speak English? I don't even know, bro. Do whatever you're going to do. Ha ha. Like, oh, fuck this. Just get out of here. Driving away like, ha ha, I don't know. I'm a fake racist. Anyone here a real racist? Give it up. No one in from Barry? Fucking right, Barry. Some parts of the States, they get really mad at people for being from different places, which is weird because it doesn't even make sense historically in some parts of America. Like, for example, in the southern states like Texas, they always get mad at Mexicans. They say, like, where the fuck do these Mexicans come from? We got to build a wall around Texas to keep the Mexicans out. Where do the Mexicans come from? Like, read a book, man. 120 years ago, Texas was Mexico. You stole it from them. That's where they're coming from. You can't take a place over and then say, this place is infested with people that live here, you know? That's like all of us taking over Buffalo, New York, and then saying, where are all these obese children coming from? We can't get mad at them. That's where they grow. There are kids in Buffalo the size of Buffalo. Did you know that? That's true. They sweat popcorn chicken there. Did you know that? That's true. That's a true thing I made up. That's true. We got a good show for you guys tonight. There's something else I want to talk about. Oh, yeah. Talk about Rob Ford one more time. I got to get this on tape. I've done it a lot lately, but he's running for re-election, and I'm going to put this on YouTube at the same time, and we'll both get famouser. I love Rob Ford. People talk shit about Rob Ford a lot, but he's done things that make me proud as a Torontonian, you know? A lot of people don't bring it up. He's accomplished things that other people have never accomplished in the history of the world, Rob Ford, you know? I mean, he's a fat crackhead. Take a minute to appreciate that for a second. You know how hard it is to not even just be like an average-sized crackhead? You know, people smoke crack and then they start climbing shit and running immediately. But he says, no, no. Every day Rob Ford gets up and for breakfast he puts a big fat cheeseburger on a plate, puts a line of cocaine on the cheeseburger, snorts the line of cocaine, then immediately snorts that cheeseburger. Like a mayor. Like a fucking mayor. He also had a festival. Did you know that? Rob Ford had a fucking festival this summer called Ford Fest. And like all these, it's true, all these people came out. It was like Woodstock for fat illiterate people. It was fucking hilarious. So all these backyard wrestling matches and shit just broke out of nowhere. It was fucking great, right? It's a weird dude though. You think about it, like a lot of bad things about him, but also he's got great tits. Have you seen Rob Ford's tits? Oh, they're nice. He loves Rob Ford's tits. It's great stuff. He's like a German milkmaid, you know? If that guy runs, it's like watching Baywatch if it was filmed in Etobicoke. You know what I mean? Some people stand in the darkness. Little shimmy for you, Orf. What up? Yeah, fucking extra if you're sitting in the front row. Did you bring a raincoat? It's going to get messy up in the front, bud. But we're going to have a great fucking night tonight. We have your first guest this evening is a wicked dude. And he hosts a... Oh, no, you don't host a show at the Cage, do you? That's Merv and... Okay. Every now and again, this guy will host a wicked show at a place called The Cage on College on Thursday? Yep. Cool. On Thursday, he's absolutely wicked. He's ripping it up. Give it up for the awesome Andrew Barr, everybody. Your first comedian. Let him hear it. Take a cruise, homie. You and me aren't the same kind.
Bitches like you always spitting the same rhymes. Hey, hi. Hello. That's true. Come check out my show at The Cage. If ever... What? Oh, not for me. Okay, just themselves. That's fine. The Cage has $2 half pints, just a heads up. Cheapest drinks in the city if you're ever into getting drunk instead of getting high. Or both. Both is fun. Anyway, hi, everybody. Bryan was talking about Rob Ford. I'm going to agree with him. I'm okay with Rob Ford. I think Rob Ford's funny. And I kind of hope he gets reelected, actually, because... You know what? I think it's universally accepted that politicians are villains. And isn't it nice if the villain is someone stupid that we can catch every single time? You know? Rob Ford is like Team Rocket from Pokemon. You know he's gonna lose at the end of every episode. His plans always suck. The start of every one of Rob Ford's plots is let's get drunk. The man is a moron, you know? he's so far from the worst politician, he's just the worst at hiding things, you know? Like, do you have any idea how many prostitutes Stephen Harper has probably murdered and we just don't know because he's good at his job? Look at that man's steely eyes and tell me he doesn't murder prostitutes. That guy has a dungeon, definitely. Ford's not smart enough for that stuff, man. Think about this. He's the mayor of the biggest city in the whole country. He has so many resources at his disposal, and then he goes and gets his own crack. That is monumentally stupid. Like, you couldn't send someone? You don't have an intermediate to do that for you? And then not only does he go and get the crack, he stays there, and he smokes it with his dealers. And he's like, why do you guys have your cell phone in my face? That's weird. It's like, just fucking take that shit home, man, and smoke it in the basement, and then spend some time with your family like a fucking adult. You know? You can have an addiction, just be home in time for dinner, that's all. It's weird, because he's not a man who looks like he misses a meal. But anyway, I digress. Good to be here at Vapor Central. I always like performing for you guys. I perform in bars a lot, which can be kind of a bummer, because everybody's drunk and loud, and then I come here, and you guys are quiet. And you just kind of stare at me, which is cool. It's a fun place. I've never, like, people in bars, they yell at me. You know, I've never had somebody heckle me here. The closest I've had to a heckle here is someone was playing Jenga in the back and the tower fell over. And, like, I couldn't even really be mad because, you know what, I've been there and that sucks. I kind of felt for them. My heart went out. It's funny, they got all those board games in the back. They've got Monopoly in the back, which is crazy. Can you imagine being here long enough to play a whole game of Monopoly? You would look like Mr. Magoo. All the smoke would just shrink your whole body. I actually played Monopoly once while I was high, and I wouldn't recommend it, man. Because, like, when you're high, you don't want to charge people for things. You know? Like, I had, like, two hotels on Boardwalk, and my buddy landed on it. And I was like, oh, fuck. Just sleep in your car, man. It's cool. Or your thimble, whatever you got. I've been feeling like a real dick ever since I got this job at my dad's hotel. All right. That's nonsense. Jesus, I've been here for a few minutes, and I haven't even told you guys anything about me. We haven't even been acquainted. My name is Andrew. Here's the thing about me. I'm 22 years old and going bald, which we can all agree is a little soon. A little soon for that to be happening, you know? Balding is unfortunate regardless of your age. It is much worse when you have acne still. You know, I'm kind of like half the worst part of being 14 and half the worst part of being 40 all at the same time. I'm like a centaur, but I suck. You know? You see a centaur and you're like, oh, that's the coolest. What a practical interweaving of species. You see me and you're like, oh. Why is that teenager so stressed out? Could he be going through a divorce? Hey guys, welcome to the show. Thanks for coming. We're just talking about my stupid head. I hit a new stage in balding this month that I'm not at all excited about. Now when I chew my food, you can see muscles in the side of my forehead moving. You know? Which is weird, you know? Now whenever I have lunch, people are like, is that guy trying to move shit with his mind? Hey, Magneto, I don't think there's any metal in your egg salad sandwich. Why don't you give that shit a rest? But don't feel bad for me for going bald, though. Feel bad for the people who cut my hair. I feel like the most underappreciated form of art is cutting the hair of a balding man. Imagine someone was like, hey, I want you to paint me a masterpiece. Here's an enormous canvas and barely any paint. And all of the paint is brown. See what you can do. All right, that one tanked. That's fine. One of the trickiest things about being a comedian in Toronto is figuring out what jokes work for potheads, because it's strange. I have really good ones that I'll use in the club, and you guys are like, no. No fucking way, buddy. Nice try, though. I see that shit. I know you rehearsed that. Nice try, punk. Anyway, I know what you guys like. We're going to talk about genitals now for a minute. You know what? I think it's the year 2014. We need to stop making fun of each other's genitals. Because it happens. Oh, don't pretend it doesn't. You ladies, you like to make fun of us with our little tiny whatnots. And we like to make fun of you with your flippity-floppity hoo-has. And it's enough, all right? Everybody's genitals in their own wonderful way are equally gross. The nicest dick still looks like raw chicken parts, you know? I've heard some ladies refer to their vaginas as a flower, and I'm sorry, but no way, that would be the meanest looking flower. If you saw that flower growing in the sidewalk, you would cross the street. Like, I'm in a bad neighborhood right now. What is it, Sherburn and Dundas? I'm fucking out of here. Shouldn't make fun, though. I'm not here to make fun. I have an uncircumcised penis, and that's as bad as you can do. That's like a snake eyes in the craps game of genitals. One woman laughs. She's like, I've seen that. You're right. It's gross and hilarious. Anytime a woman has ever sucked my dick, I've been like, bless your little heart. Are you sure? Look how awful it looks, you know? It looks like something that should jump out and scare you in a haunted house. I would never suck one of these, you know? They're far too extraterrestrial looking, you know? I'd be worried that if I sucked one, it'd be like the movie Alien, and 2 hours later, a smaller uncircumcised penis would burst out of my chest cavity, and then I'd have to suck that one also. Horrifying. Anyway, enough of the genital talk. We'll talk about buttholes now. We'll go from the front to the back. Like a good book, or like any book. Anyway. I think it's crazy that in North America, we use toilet paper instead of a bidet. Because would you guys feel more clean if you had a shower or if you just wiped your body down with paper towels? You understand what I'm saying, Vapor Set? In order to clean anything, you get it wet, except for your own butthole. And that's so gross. Animals have cleaner buttholes than we do, and they're just licking them. You know, it's purely a moisture game. Have you guys seen a cat's butthole? Don't answer that. I know you have. If you've met one cat, you've seen a cat's butthole. They open with that. That is the first thing they show you. The confidence that takes is staggering. And it's well-deserved confidence. It is pristine back there. I would sooner look at a cat's butthole than any one of your buttholes. It's amazing. They're trying to teach you. That's why they show you that. They're like, hey, you see this big fella? Yeah, get a good look. This could be you. Just a little bit of water. You know? That joke is always like half people laughing at the joke and like half people who are like, oh my God, I need to go home and clean my butthole. Why is that man so right about my butthole? Anyways, what else for you fine folk? It's been a fun summer, man. A lot of cool stuff going on. Anybody go out and celebrate Pride this year? That was a good time. A couple people in the back, that's great. I celebrated Pride this year, by which I mean I went downtown and did MDMA, which I think is the same thing. That is all the gay community asks of us, and I am happy to oblige them every year. How do you guys celebrate? You get high? All right. I love you. Now that I'm on MDMA, I love you twice as much. I'm a straight man, but supportive of the gay community. I think it's silly that people are still homophobic, because like, even if for some reason you hate gay people, you have to pick your battles, right? Overpopulation is the world's biggest problem, and gay sex has resulted in exactly zero children. So that's pretty helpful, actually, when you think about it, you know? Like, I don't understand how someone could hate same-sex marriage more than the earth running out of the resources that it needs to support human life. It seems a little extreme, you know? All I'm trying to say here is I think we should all be gay for 30 years. I'll do it if you guys do it. Takers? No, come on, think about it, it would be awesome. The population would drop so low, and then in the future, if somebody tried to be homophobic, you could be like, well, I don't know, remember when everyone was gay? You were previously gay. Anyway, one person really liked that, and that's all you need sometimes here, you know? Fucking love it when you guys watch me on the TV instead of right here. It's so funny. Anyway. A homophobe never has a good argument either, you know? You always find they're like, oh man, being gay is just unnatural. And it's like, being gay is not unnatural, you know? Like, the human body is built specifically for gay sex to happen. All right? Follow me here, friends. Inside of my butt, all right, is the male prostate. And if you press something against the male prostate, well, hey, it feels pretty good. But in order to reach it, You need something long and tubular. Like, oh, I don't know, a throbbing cock. So what's that little button doing in there? Who put that there? Did God put that in there so that my loyal wife could finger blast my butt? Thank you. That joke is much more controversial in its original Russian. Anyway. I've always found it strange that the Russians are like a homophobic country because they invented vodka, which is the number one cause of girls making out worldwide. You know? Girls making out, like the number two cause is actually being a lesbian, and number one is birthday cake flavored Smirnoff. So, bit of a counterproductive move on Russia's part, is what I'm saying. But anyways, while we're talking about groups of people that are often discriminated against, I want to talk about transgendered people for a minute. Obviously one of the most discriminated against people left on our planet, and I think that's awful. I think it's a wonderful thing that we can change people's gender. I hope one day we can do it faster. I want that shit in a spray can, you know, like Balls Be Gone or something. Think about how convenient that would be if you were at like a sausage fest of a party and you could just whip out a can and be like, all right, draw straws, boys. Some of us are ladies tonight. 24-hour penis prevention guaranteed. If vagina lasts more than a day, consult your doctor or enjoy your new lifestyle. Whichever you prefer. Well, it bums me out that people being transgendered is still like a hotly debated subject, you know? And it's always tied into like religion or moral issues and stuff, and that stuff's boring. Put that over there. Here's how you should look at it. Gender reassignment surgery costs a lot of money. And if somebody spends $50,000 on something, you tell them it's nice. Yeah? Doesn't matter what it is. Your buddy buys a $50,000 car and you don't like the car, you just shut the fuck up about it, you know? And you say, hey, congratulations on your new car. I hope you're really happy in your new car, Jim. Jane, sorry. That's going to take some getting used to. All right, that one ends a little soft, but there's a good point there. I'm keeping it. Anyway, I'll do one more thing and mahooze it, and then I'll go, oh boy, porn's getting strange. I saw Bukkake for the first time recently. You guys seen Bukkake? If you haven't seen Bukkake, hey, don't. My friend told me what it was. And he was like, yeah, it's a group of men in a circle and they all jerk off on a woman. And I was like, it can't be that. That can't be what it is. And then I watched it, and that's exactly what it is. It's this weird, introverted kind of porn where nobody's touching anyone else. It's not even sex, really. No one's touching anyone. I feel like that should be a prerequisite to porn, should be like social skills, you know? If you're gonna be in porn, you should want to talk to and touch other people. And the etiquette of Bukkake I find interesting, like, if you finish first, can you go? All right, you guys, that's been my time for tonight. Thank you so much. Give it up for your host, everybody. Right on, women. Thanks.
Andrew fucking Barr, everybody. Give it up. The world's funniest 8-year-old. That's a great question. Can you leave right after? The fuck, you have to stick around and watch everybody else finish off for? You're innovative and intelligent. Yeah, guys, we have some more stuff for you right now. Maybe we'll go into some videos in a second. But I thought they were doing it. Yeah, I'm going to find out what drugs people are on right now. So give it up if you're on MDMA. One guy. Just feeling his nipples in the back. This is the best comedy show ever! Acid. Anybody? No? Anyone on steroids? Give it up. We're like, right here! Right here, faggot! Right here! What do you want to do about it? You never know. I never understand steroids, because one of the main side effects in males with steroid use is erectile dysfunction. So your cock doesn't even work, you know? You spend all this time pumping iron, trying to look attractive, and you can't even fuck the people you attract, you know? Some kind of sick joke. That's why it's way better just be yourself, be a small guy with a huge cock, and surprise the fuck out of women, you know? You're like, I'm just gonna go ahead and zip. Holy shit! Look at that! Say, right? Right? You followed your heart, and this is your reward. There you go. You weren't a superficial bitch. Boom. Orgasms. There you have it. Didn't even ask me what car I had. Good for you. What was I gonna fucking? Oh, let's just do the drunk elephants, Chris, real fast. We've shown a million different weeks worth of videos of animals getting fucked up. We found dolphins that get high on pufferfish. We found monkeys that do heroin. And this is just some elephants. We've seen different animals get fucked up on this same fruit. What happens is the fruit falls off the trees and it gets fermented, and then they eat it, and then they act like dickheads. They're young, too. They're like fucking high school kids getting all hammered. Elephant prom, what up? He does what we do, Orf. What's this music they put behind it, too? Sounds like one of those narco songs from Mexico, you know? Like the drunk dad trying to figure out what to do with his drunk kids. Just get in the van, I'll take it. Oh my god, what's he doing with his drunk kid? No, no! No! Oh no! Just like us, see? Aww. I think, how much longer is in this video? Okay, it's a minute. I can handle a minute more of this. I can handle another hour of this shit. They just take me home, man. Get off the ground. I can't. I like the way the tile feels on my face. Fuck off. Oh, he's kicking him now. Oh. I like how the other one's holding it together a bit, you know what I mean? We'll make sure he gets home all right. Hold my ears, I gotta puke. All right, so there's some drunk elephants. So yeah, every fucking week, we've managed to find another drunk-ass, fucked-up animal. And it doesn't end. Like, there's no shortage of these videos, and every time I look for more, there's like 8 new ones. So we're gonna keep doing this till this show fucking burns to the ground, I don't care. The other thing we like to do is show you guys videos of some like new innovations that are going on and stuff like that. Crazy things in the world of science. Hi. And what we're gonna do is, this shit blew my fucking mind this week. Okay, you guys see the video this summer of a hoverboard? Where it was like a fake hoverboard video with Tony Hawk and the guy from, Christopher Lloyd from, you know, Back to the Future or whatever. They're like, it's a real hoverboard. And it was obviously a fake fucking hoverboard. They made a fucking hover bike, and this is real, man. And they're testing it on people right now.
Is it a bird? Is it a plane? No, of course not. But it is a hover bike. Thanks to a Kickstarter project and a dedicated team of engineers at UK company Malloy Aeronautics, this new hover bike could be soaring in an airspace near you.
Oh, it's so cool.
However, this small drone is just a one-third scale version for mass production, and a full-sized one will be flown by remote and piloted by a person.
When I got my helicopter license, I realized that the helicopter as a design has a lot of improvements that need to be made, and one of them is safety and reliability.
It's the coolest nerd on the earth right here.
Very complex machines. And,
fucking inventing hover bikes.
Yeah, but my goal was to see where we could strip away the complexity and increase the safety, and that's basically where the hover bike came from.
The team first planned to launch the hoverbike as an unmanned aerial vehicle before securing an aviation certificate for a manned model. The mini hoverbike can reach top speeds of 45 miles per hour, but don't get your hopes up just yet. It could be a few years before we see them in our skies.
Oh, my hopes are so up already. I don't even care. Was that it? Fuck, that looks so cool. How badass would it be to like pick up a girl on a date with a fucking hover bike? You know what I mean? She doesn't even know what it is. You want to go see a movie? She's like, fuck, in the future? Of course I do. That's like the POV version of it. Isn't that so rad? So anyways, Chris is right too. Why do they have to put like the most horrifying robot on the top of it? Just looks like it's trying to kill us all. Anyway, I thought that was pretty rad. I'll tell some more jokes before we get our next guest up here. I feel like it's a little too informative. I should have, like, shown the drunk video second. So you guys are into it. Now you're just all thinking about hover bikes and shit. Get the fuck out of here. Okay, fine. That was fun. So, yeah, I was like sort of hanging out the other day. We were talking about the 420 rally. Did you guys go to that shit? Did you guys go? We had a big one this year. You're so enthusiastic about it, too. It was a great one this year. We had 15,000 people came out to get high in one fucking place. Can you believe that? 420. I almost said 420 people. 15,000 people on 420 all get high at the same time. All this smoke rises in the air, and all these helicopters start smashing into each other and shit like that. It was dope. Also, weird thing about 420, it's also Adolf Hitler's birthday. Did you guys know that? Isn't that fucking weird? He would hate what happened to his birthday so fucking much. But like, this is not what I had in mind! I wanted death and destruction. All they do is hug each other and rub each other's scalps. This is bullshit. I'm going to kill all of them. All of the you know what? Forget about it. I'm going to go back to art school. If anyone has any pointers. Those are sweet. I think there's a great day tonight. Great night tonight. Starting to get high. It's like doing comedy inside of a bong in this place. I fucking love it. This is like what I imagine the inside of Snoop Dogg's lungs look like. You know, just a bunch of people partying. And in the meantime, though, we're going to bring up your second comedian of the evening. Then after her, we're going to give away a bong to you guys. And then we got your awesome headliner. So please, guys, be really awesome and welcome the fabulously talented. She hosts at Hotbox Cafe every Thursday. Give it up for the wicked Amanda Day, everyone. Let her hear it.
Hey, guys. I'm high, too. Nobody thinks it is cute when I get as drunk as those elephants did. They're just like, fucking keep it together, lady. Before we get into anything, here's a little fact about me, just so you can get to know me. I have never given a hand job. That wasn't also a blowjob. So, no half measures. I learned that from Breaking Bad. That was my takeaway from the show. Suck the whole dick. Guys, I was at a party, right? And somebody offered me MDMA. So I took it, because I'm not much of a drinker. And got a party somehow, and I could feel it like starting to kick in, like kind of working, but it also felt like I just felt fried, like I thought I was gonna take MDMA and be like, everything's amazing, I just wanna dance, but like, instead I just felt kind of fucked up and not like the right reaction I should have been getting, so I immediately like Googled for answers. I was just on my phone like, why can't I roll on Molly? And I looked it up, and what Google told me was, like, it could be a couple of different reasons. One of the reasons can be, like, it could be a dosage thing. You might need a little bit more to get rolling. And the other reason that they said was, if you're on certain types of antidepressants, then ecstasy is just not going to work on you for whatever reason. And I was like, oh, that's got to be the reason why. Because I've been taking antidepressants lately, and I'm like, that's got to be the reason why it didn't work. But I can't believe something I'm taking to keep me from being sad is keeping me from being so happy. Kind of a double-edged sword. I had a weird thing happen to me on social media. I follow this writer. You probably wouldn't know him by name or anything like that, but he's written for like the Sarah Silverman program and Parks and Rec and stuff like that. So I think he's a funny guy, and I follow him. And one day he tweeted out to the world, hey ladies, just so you know, the best way to make me to get in my pants is to make me laugh. And so I wrote back to him, I can make your penis laugh, is that cool? And then I hashtagged it, women can be creeps too, hashtag yes all women. And then I sent it off into the Twitterverse. And immediately was just like hit with a wave of regret. Like, what the fuck did I just do? Because it's the kind of thing where like, if the genders were reversed and someone sent something like that to me, I'd just immediately post it on my Facebook like, look how people talk to me. Like, just like, ugh. So I was just like, that's a creepy, weird thing to do to a complete stranger. Just be like, you can't be like, I'll make your pussy chuckle. Like, it just doesn't work at all. So I was like, what the fuck is my problem? I'm such a creep. And then I decided, like, okay, I'll just delete the tweet. Hopefully nobody saw it. You know, everything's fine. And then he immediately followed me back. So I don't understand how society works. That's all. It's just a fact. I've been online dating. Can you believe it? This treasure. And I got into it sincerely. You know, I was hoping, like, oh, it'd be nice to see if I can meet someone and see if we can build something together. But what I found it's really useful for is just fucking strangers on the internet. So if that's your bag, I highly recommend it. It really works. But I had a guy over to my place recently, and he spent the night. And in the morning, he had to get up and go to work. And so he turned to me and he said, hey, is it cool if I hop in your shower? I don't want to go to work smelling like sex. And I was like, wow, we're very different people. So I don't give a fuck. I'll babysit your kid with dick breath. I don't care. Do not shake my hand after the show. It's not sweat. Just balls, guys. I went on a first date recently, and I hadn't been on a first date in a while, so I was kind of excited. I've just been seeing the regulars, you know what I'm saying? So I was into some new flavor, and I was talking to this guy on the internet, he was like exactly my type, you know what I mean? And my type has been described by friends as potentially homeless, so if you can just picture that in your minds, you've got it exactly. And this guy had like a broken tooth too, and like that just added to it. It was like, I broke my tooth 2 weeks ago, and I was like, never fix it. Couldn't get abscessed? I want it. No, you don't want that. So like, you know, it was sort of the situation where I was like, I was already really attracted to him. And I hadn't had sex with anyone new in a while, so I was like, you know, as long as I'm going to go on this date with this guy, and as long as he doesn't, like, say anything stupid or is racist or something, then, like, he's in. You know what I'm saying? So, like, I already went into my mind, into the date with that mindset. And sometimes what happens in online dating is someone will say, hey, why don't you just come over to my house and hang out? And sometimes I'm horny enough that I don't care. I'm just like, no safety precautions needed. Just go over to his house. So I go over there, and we're hanging out, we're drinking and stuff like that. The date's going pretty well. And we hadn't had like a drugs conversation before getting together. So I like had brought a little bit of weed with me, like not to be too presumptuous, but just sort of like, you know, we didn't talk what we were into, but it would be good. So the date's going good, and I decide now's a good time to bring up, like, hey, if you want, I can roll us a joint, we can smoke some weed. And he said, I don't really smoke pot. Like, when I smoke, I get really internal and into my head and that kind of thing. And I was like, oh, I totally understand. Probably not the state of mind you want to be in on a first date. That's totally cool. And he was like, yeah, it's just not really my thing. But I do have all this speed, though. And I was like, no speed for me, thanks. But you do you. So he cut up a line of speed, and he just hacked it up his nose. And I was like, okay. I thought I was a little worried for a while because I don't like being around cokeheads because they're like too intense and in my face. And I was worried that like speed would be kind of the same thing. And I was like, no, I'm not going to be able to fuck him. He's going to annoy me. And turned out guy handled his speed very well. Just able to carry on a normal conversation and be pleasant. So so I fucked him. he wasn't racist. So, but here's the thing. If you're fucking someone on speed, they're pretty much always like overstimulated and kind of like coasting the edge, but there's nothing to kind of push it on through to the other side. So we're having like marathon style sex, and eventually we're taking breaks and stuff like that, but eventually we're getting into like hour six of the fuck fest. And at this point, as you can possibly imagine, my vagina is just destroyed at that point. It was just sort of like, you can't put anything else in there anymore. Like, it's done. It's sanded free. Like, it's just disappeared now. So as pleasantly as I possibly could say it, I was sort of like, it would be really sexy if you came now. Like, we can end this. So he goes, I know what to do. And he grabs a vibrator out of his own closet and shoves it up his own ass. And then I blew him till he came like Yosemite Sam shooting guns off into the air. Just pew, 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 pew. So he's getting a call back. and I'm making smart choices with my life. Ow! I'll say one last thing and then I'll go. I once had a guy fall asleep in my mouth while I was blowing him. Didn't do any wonders for the old self-esteem. Had to pop a couple antidepressants. But he did. I tried to take the most positive spin on it that I could. Like, first of all, he was very drunk. And secondly, that's how I like to think. That's just how warm and comforting my blowjobs are. Like, they just make you feel so safe. Just get a nice mug of hot cocoa and put on your footy pajamas and get a nice snuggly blowjob into dreamland. And some of you might think, like, Amanda, that sounds pretty great to me. but it's very frustrating for me when I'm like, I'm going to go to town on this dong. And then you're like, oh, you're asleep now. Where's the line of consent here? Is it when you put your dick in my mouth? We're getting into a weird gray rape area I'm not very comfortable with. And secondly, I've had people come up to me after shows and be like, you have to understand, Amanda, that feels really good. And I was like, yeah, I'm sure it feels great. The problem is that it can never really be returned, you know what I mean? Like, I don't think I could ever be eaten out to sleep, you know? Just be lying there like, all right, I gotta get up for work in the morning. All right, thanks guys, enjoy the rest of the night.
Amanda Day, everyone, the world's horniest leprechaun. Give it up for her. That was awesome. Whew. Holy shit, that was a lot of pussy talk. I felt like I fucked her by the end of that. You guys too? That was fantastic. We're going to give away this bong in a second. That will happen, I promise you. But I was going to talk a second. She was talking about, you know, guys being rude and stuff like that. And it's true. Men are fucking pigs, you know. But I try to be a gentleman. I try to be a gentil man, if you will. Yeah. So, like, for example, if I go to a girl's house and I don't know her that well and I have to go to the bathroom, I'll put my whole penis in the toilet water so she can't hear me pee. See? Yeah. I'm a fucking gentleman. I'm a gentil man. I'm such like a gentleman, you know, that like if I go to that same toilet and there's a little bit of poop on the porcelain, I'll spend the whole pee trying to pee it off in the toilet so the next guy doesn't have to see it. It's called being a fucking gentleman. These are my fake cufflinks I keep fixing. People don't like it when you talk about poo, but I think it's funny, you know. I think it's funny because, like, people won't admit to the kind of shit that they see, right? Like, everybody knows in this whole room, you go to a public toilet anywhere in the city, if there's five stalls, one of them, someone just hasn't flushed. They just decided, who the fuck cares? Why would you, who the, you know, this is a lot of work right here. That's fucking, and you can look at me like, ew, you're gross, but you know exactly what the fuck I'm talking about. You know, there's probably like three of you in here right now to like, yes, it's me. I've shat in every Starbucks in Toronto and I never buy anything. Fucking gross. So what they've done to combat this shit is they put laser sensors on toilets. You guys know that? It's the future of shitting, yeah? Like you, the weird thing about these things is like sometimes it's bizarre that somebody even has to have a laser sensor that automatically flushes. Like, I just don't understand where you grow up that's a thing where you, oh, what a great shit. I'm just going to flush. No, wait. More people need to see this. I'll leave my email address on the wall, see if anyone has any pointers. I want to grow as a person. So anyway, these toilets, the weird thing with the laser sensors is, first of all, those toilets are super fucking powerful, aren't they? Like, you could flush a handgun down most of these things, right? And secondly, sometimes they flush when you're still fucking on them. Has that ever happened to you guys? Like, you bend over to tie up your shoe and you go outside of the laser sensor and all of a sudden it sounds like a Harrier jet's taking off under your asshole? Just which is not the kind of sound you want to hear from something your balls are inside of. You know. I just don't want to lose them like that. What's really in the sewers? Ninja Turtles. That's all I was taught. And I think that new movie is great, so I don't care what you guys say. Did you guys see the new Turtles flick? No, it's, I think it's dope, man. It, like, whatever. Yeah, it's not as great as the first one, but what is? Nothing. And if you can't appreciate a bunch of cartoon fucking mutant turtles beating the shit out of ninjas, I don't know where you grew up, but you're a sad person, man. I'm so bad for you. It's a quick thing, too. This is some heavy subject matter. The you guys hear about this guy that got beheaded, the journalist in the Middle East. So they beheaded this journalist, and what's weird about it is in the video, this is a picture of it. We're not going to show it to you, don't worry. But like the dude in that black garb is from fucking London, England. I don't know if you guys saw this video, but they have this guy on his knees like, America's killed all these people. I renounce my American citizenship. And the guy who's like has him hostage is like, that's fucking right, Obama. You see this bullshit, isn't it? And you're like, what the fuck is happening here? Is this guy taking this video from some desert outside South London? What the fuck is happening? This is fucking bullshit. It's like, why did you grow up in such a cool place? And you're like, I want to dress like a ninja and fucking kill people in the desert, you fucking loser. But it'd be funnier if like different accents came out of them, like you know, like a fucking Chinese accent came out of it. Okay, you give us all the hostage or this guy gets it one more time. Like, Obama'd be like, no. Okay, come on, don't be a dick. I'll fucking kill him. No, you won't. No, you won't. There's more to that, but I'll get to it some other day. Right now, we have a headliner that I'm really happy to have up here. He's a wicked dude. We're going to give away a bong before he comes up here. So what we need for this bong hitting competition is two people from the audience. We need you to come up here. You have to be able to hit a bong. Yeah. So you got this guy's already got a bong. You want to come up? Let's do it. Leave your bong, though. I got a bong for you. He brought his own. That's cool. What's your name, man? Marcus. Hey, Marcus. I'm Brian. What's up? Can I get one more volunteer? Anybody want to come up? Raise your hand right now, and you can win a bong. Yeah, there's one. Come on up, dude. And this is Aaron. Hey, can we give it up for our Vapor Central staff, everyone? Working hard and high for you. Is that dude coming? Where's the other guy? Ah, fuck. There's. Hey. How are you? What's your name, man?
Jordan.
Hey, Jordan and Brian. What's up? Okay, let's give it up for both of them for coming up here, first of all, guys. It's scary under these lights. They're high. Hey, Jordan, just watch your foot there, bro. Watch your foot there, dude. I'm just going to pull this out from underneath you. All right, so here's the rules of the game, guys. This is the bong that's up for stake. One at a time, we'll go with Jordan first. You're going to hit the bong. When you're done smoking the bong, you give it to me. We're going to play you some music, and you're going to dance as you blow out the smoke. And we're going to see who's better at getting high and then getting down. Sound like fun, Vapor Central? We're going to see some dancing. Okay, so come on up here, Jordan. We're going to count them down. 3, 2, 1. Then everyone chant toke. Ready? 3, 2, 1. Toke, 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 toke. Toe. Oh, he's clear. The boy's a pro. Give him some music, Chris. Dance it up, buddy. It's all yours. Dance. Dance, motherfucker. What are you doing? Dance. The music? Oh, you're not going to do anything? What do you want? Oh. All right, man. I don't know what to do. I think we're gonna get. Yeah, we need a competition. Yeah, look, he doesn't even want to do it. What's that?
I'll take another point.
It's okay, man. You just have to dance. How about we play you some music again and you dance and then we'll stay in the competition? Can we do that? Is that cool? Okay. Well, we're gonna have to just like grab another person from the audience then, man. All right. So thanks for coming up. That was so awkward. It's just me and you now, dude. Fuck you want to do? I just want to give him the fucking bong.
Awesome.
Well, shit, man. That's the first time I've done fucking maybe 300 of these competitions. I've never had someone just go, no. All you do is get high, then have fun. No. I won't do it. And then I feel bad for you because you got to sit up here while fucking I make fun of this guy. All right, we're going to get one more person up here. Can we get somebody else up here to do this competition, or should we just me and him get fucking high and dance together? You let him do it? Okay, well, let's count him down. Ready? Come on up here, bro. We're going to count him down. 3, 2, 1. Everyone chant toke for our dude staying up here. Ready? 3, 2, 1. Toke, 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 toke. Toe, toe. Oh, he's clear. Yes, sir. Give him some music, Chris. Oh, shit. Fuck yeah. Well, I think that. Oh, shit. Did you just moonwalk? Ah, you would have lost anyway. Don't fucking worry about it. We get back up here. This game is in shambles. Okay, that was awesome, man. We'll just give it to him. What do you guys think? That was a fucking moonwalk. That was some crazy shit. There you go, bro. Thanks for coming out. You're welcome, man. Cheers. Thanks for dancing. Thanks for having a good time. Give it up for him, everybody. That was so weird, Aaron. I know. I'm fucking... All right, guys. We're going to bring up your headliner right now. That was so strange. He goes, the guy's like, I'll take another bong hit if you want. Why not? Fucking give you more free weed for that. Who cares? Are you still having fun, Vapor Central? You ready for your headliner? Let me hear you. Come on, Vapor Central, give it up. We got one more act for you this evening. He's absolutely awesome from New York City. Get up for the awesome Ray DeVito, everybody. Let him hear it. Clap it up, Vapor Central.
For Bryan? That's Bryan. Bryan Ogorman. Having this. Fuck yeah, man. What's up, dancer? I like it. Yeah, that other dude just got up here and looked at you. It's like, fucking really? It's like, I'm just gonna, I like yours. What? You were waiting for that. Like, you were gonna have sex with him anyways, right? Like, you were going to... Like, that means a lot for a girl. Like, once I see you can dance, like, if she was on the fence, now she's definitely going to. Yeah, see, yeah, he's like, your night's getting better and better the more we go. This is new to me. We have nothing like this. I'm from the States. We have nothing as cool as this. This is, all right, yeah, boo this state. Yeah, I'm saying this is cool. I'm saying, I'm complimenting you, and you're booing the compliment. Boo. It's not that awesome here. Boo. This is cool as shit. I went to a Blue Jays game Sunday. You guys lost. Your right fielder blew the... I was fucking into it. I was rooting for you guys. But I bought tickets from the scalper. I live in New York City. I'm from Cleveland, Ohio. But we bought tickets to the game, $50 tickets for $20. And the dude, like, walked us to the gate. He was the nicest... I was like, wow, if that happened in New York City, if I bought a scalper ticket, he's like gone immediately. Your guy's like, fucking no, come on, man, I got you. That's cool. You look like you fell asleep on that couch in 2007 and just haven't left. Like, you're just like, what's up? These guys are out of here, peace. I'm high, I never perform high, but I'm like, fuck it. Went in rum. Yeah, I took a hit out of that same bong. You're the one that brought up the bong, or he did? Who did the one behind there? Because I did the same. Oh, you brought your own. You were so fucking ready for this dance competition. You have no idea. He had knee pads on underneath his jeans. Yeah, like a Jabberwocky's mask he was going to put on if need be. He was going to do this. Gonna be great. This is fucking awesome. I don't want to leave Toronto. I like it. This happened to me too. I met Bryan Sunday. We did a show together. It was awesome. It was fucking a backyard show. There's no microphones or anything. It's packed. so cool, such a fucking cool vibe. And he's like, yeah, come do this Wednesday. So here I am. Friday, I got a show I got to do. But that's it. That's all I'm in town for. But we went to the Tom Petty concert last night. Yeah, fuck yeah, I did. I asked you about it in 2008, right here, when he came around. But we got kicked out for smoking weed. Yeah, and that was the coolest thing ever. Like, I threw away my weed and my joint in front of with the cop, and he just escorted me out. Like, that was it. Like, my day could have really been fucked. That was like the friendliest thing ever. All right, let's do some jokes. Most awkward comedy show I've ever did. Not this one. This is fucking cool. Only thing I'm scared is falling through the fucking windows, going through Times Square. This past December, here's the deal. As a comedian, around the holidays, we do these corporate parties, and they pay well, but there's rules. Have to be clean, politically correct. So I show up for this fiber optics company. I asked a little old lady who hired me. I'm like, hey, are there any rules, anything you want me to say or not say? And she goes, oh, no, you can just do your jokes, but if you can, please say the C word. That is what she told me at a completely clean show. And I was like, well, I don't really use the C word, but you're paying the money. So, yeah, I'll get it in there. Why not? Clearly being sarcastic, I go, I'll say it 5 times in the first 10 minutes. She grabs my arm and goes, that would be great. Because we got a lot of Catholics and they'll love it. So now to make sure that we're on the same page, I have to ask her, I go, hey, by the way, what is the C word you're talking about? And she says, Christmas. Yeah, I am glad that I asked. Right? Because there's a whole other C word out there just floating around. Anyone who thinks word Christmas is too edgy, then they're probably not into the real C word. Like, I have no idea. So like an asshole, I start explaining to her what my C word was. Because I'm like, we're both adults. But in her innocent, adorable little world, there was no other C word outside of Christmas. So she thinks I'm the most repulsive human being she's ever met. So to prove her wrong, I wanted to do this. I wanted to walk out in front of 200 people expecting a clean show and go, hey, Merry Christmas, you cunts. I didn't. And then when everyone would be awkward, I was going to go, hang on, is that weird? I got to bring out Annabelle because she insists I say this 4 more times. That was that. I like you, man. I didn't know if you were getting the... I like how you're my gauge for this whole show. If he smiles, I know I'm doing okay. If he looks out the window, I know, like, I'm not. But you follow that. That was a long fucking joke to go through. I got you, man. I hear you. I'm poor. I'm telling you about that. But I'm having a good year, Toronto. I met you guys. In 5 out of the 8 months this year, I made a student loan payment. I've never hit it over. I've never been over 500 before. This is chartered new territory for me. Here's what happened, though. It was like February. I made a student loan payment. And then my bank immediately called me, and they asked if I approved of that transaction. Meaning that Chase Bank thinks it's more likely that a thief would pay off my debt than this guy. It's like, I'm totally okay with that one. Like, all right. Like, where did I become, I am a fucking adult now. Like, this is... Like, remember, I know I'm not young because when you're a kid, I remember drinking like 3 beers and then you tell all your friends that you drank 8. Remember when that was? Like, where did it come? Because now I'll tell my friends I drank 3 beers and I've had 28. Like, where did that line cross? I used to give a shit what I wore every day. Remember that? Like, high school, you can wear the same thing twice in 1 week. Now, like, look at me and this guy. This is our fucking August right here. This is, we just walk up August 1st. Like, this is what I'm doing. Fucking, I'll see you around Labor Day. I'll change my t-shirt. Where did that fucking happen? Because insecurities just, here's the deal. Like, insecurities, we still got them. Just everyone quits calling us on them every 2 minutes. That's it. They continue as we age. Yeah. I remember being in high school, like, walked into a room thinking I looked good. Someone would be like, hey, nice acid wash jeans, pizza face. Just feel your self-esteem crumble like a game of Jenga. But that would suck, right? That happened when we got older. That was something like, if I go into a pharmacy tomorrow, pharmacist gets on the microphone, be like, hey, DeVito, I got your medicine right here, limp dick. Shit, I went to fucking high school with that dude. Anyone in here have children at all? I'm not judging you. Here's why I don't think I can have them. I grew up in Cleveland, and I was home this summer, and my four-year-old nephew, him and I went to the swimming pool together, and we played this little game at the pool. This is why I think I'm never going to have kids. The little game we play is I swim up underneath him, I pick him up, and I throw him. It's more my game. He is cool with it. Anyways, way too crowded to be doing this. Way too crowded. And I ended up throwing the wrong kid. I don't know if any of you have ever thrown a child that you don't know. It is a new level of shame. Like, you will never feel that shameful in your life. It is. And the whole time, like, the only reason why I knew it wasn't my nephew is because this kid was smaller, so he went farther than I anticipated. Like, he just shot out of my hand. And the only thing that went through my head when I saw it wasn't my nephew, and I'm an American, so I'm like, I don't have health insurance. I don't even know if that applies to a kid. But he's safe. He missed the ladder. And I had a moment of clarity. I'm like, I should go home and never do this again. Like, I get out of here before I turn into Lenny from Mice and Men. Try to pet a kid like it's a rabbit or something. I don't know. I don't trust myself. Anyways, I go back to my sister's place. Next day, sitting at my sister's place, she's like, hey, yesterday when you were at the pool, did you see anything weird? Like, what? She goes, oh, my friend Carol, she said some lunatic showed up and just started throwing kids around. I was like, no, I think I was heading back here. That's that. God, I'm high. I'm having fun. I'm single? Yeah. All right, here we're not. It's not. Here's what I've been doing. I would like a girlfriend. I would like a girlfriend, Toronto, Ontario. I would like one. But I've been hooking up with my neighbor, the girl that lives in the apartment right below me. I am her booty call. Oh, they're doing that. I thought they were laughing. No, they're just taking bong hits. That's. I'm like, oh. I'm her booty call, which I've never been that. I've never been the dude that someone's called when they want a booty before. This is new. I've been the dude that people call when they want a small increment of weed. We've all been that person our whole lives. So anyways, for her birthday, I wanted to do something nice, but not too nice. So this is what I did. For one, I bought a bag of peanuts, and I taped it to her door, and I put a little sign that said, nuts for you. That's cute, right? I heard some girls here. Yeah. I got laid 30 minutes later. Holy shit. I was so amazed. I was bragging to my friends. It's the best dollar I ever spent. And my one buddy, such an asshole, was like, no, dude, the best thing you could have got if you really want to do something cute, you get her chocolate shoes. Chocolate shoes. That's, which I thought about that. That is the dumbest thing to ever get a woman. Don't ever do it. I want to take down that whole industry right now. Because here's the deal. I get it in theory. Women like chocolate. They like shoes. Let's combine it. That's like saying to a guy, like, all right, you like women. You like basketball. Enjoy your WNBA tickets. Bag of peanuts win. Chocolate shoes. Dumbest. It's the dumbest. See the dummies I got to hang out with, my friends? Thanks, buddy. I got cotton mouth so bad. You guys don't even... I'm like such a rookie on your levels. But I've been friends with all you fuckers throughout my life. Every one of you guys. In a good way. Fucking All right. Let's see what else we got. So I've been doing this. Because of that, I've been manscaping. I do that. I'm going to admit it to you guys. I do. I don't. As a dude, I don't know why we don't like to admit when we do it. Like, I don't know why we look shame. Like, it's like, yeah, it's like admitting to the world, this is what I look like when I try. I'm only going to be a 6. This is the best it's ever going to get. I'm trying, and I tap out at a 6. That's what we announce when we... But I do. I trim my eyebrows. If it didn't, my forehead would look like a caterpillar fight. I'm aware. It's intense. But this is what I did. I was on a date with a lady, and before the date, I shaved my shoulders. I just want to clarify, it's a very light dusting. It's nothing. It's nothing gross. But I do have... I get into it. I dance, put on some Jay-Z, get that hair off my shoulders. I do it. Here's the deal, though. Your shoulders are sharp. They're sharp, and I was unaware that I had an abrasion, and I wore a white T-shirt. Yeah, so she's like, what happened to you? And I'm like, what? Yeah, so she's like, did you get stabbed? Did someone hit you? I'm like, what? No. And then I looked in the mirror, and I saw that my left shoulder looked like the flag of Japan. And instead of owning it, I lied. And I go, oh, that's from flag football. And then she's like, really? You play flag football? I was like, yeah. She's like, where do you play? I'm like, Central Park. She goes, that's crazy. That's where my brother plays. What's the name of your league? I'm like, fucking League of Liars? Who gives a shit? So now I'm owning it. I don't want those scenarios. How much time am I doing? You guys want to hear a story? You guys are cool. I'll do as long as you want me to. And then, yeah. All right. I'll do a couple stories and get the fuck out of here. And anyone else from the Midwest at all? No, you guys are all Canadians then, right? Right? You've been to New York City? All right. New York City, everyone's assholes. I just want you to know. Like, I'm from the Midwest, which is Cleveland, Ohio. Kind of like you guys, we're not as cool as you guys, I admit. You're a little cooler, but fuck you, we have LeBron James now. So we're catching up. We see your Drake, and we even you up. But then you have Bieber, so you're losing a little bit. I didn't put him here. I didn't fucking make him. We have fucking Paris Hilton and shit. We got shit that's... We got crazy shit. All right. What the fuck was my highest? Oh. So my first introduction... If you've ever met anyone from Midwest America, we're very friendly. We're very nice. We're aggressively nice. Like, I'll meet a stranger, and I'm like, that's a potential friend that wants to know my thoughts. Doesn't fly in New York City at all. So the weekend I moved in, it's crazy ice storm going outside. It was so cold that I drove my car a half block to the laundromat. I go in, I'm doing my laundry. It's an ice storm going on outside, and I heard my car alarm going off. So I go outside, and nobody's out there but this 70-year-old Mexican man standing next to my car, just like looking at it. And I'm like, I take out my remote control. I'm like, I shut off my remote. I'm like, hey, man, that's my car. He's like, He's like, he looks at me. He's just staring at my car in wonderment. So I turn it off. I go back inside. As soon as I get back inside, I hear, So again, I go back outside. Now the same dude is there, just over my car, but now all my lights are on, the alarm's going off, and the trunk is open, and the guy's got his hand resting on my car. So I'm not accusing him, but I'm fucking accusing him. I'm like, hey, buddy, that's my car. That's like, it's loco. He's slapping my car. I'm like, no, I'm loco. Stay away from my shit. I'm like, there's nothing in the trunk. I'm like, Buscar, I think means to look. I don't know. And I'm like showing him nada, empty. I slam the trunk. I turn off the alarm. I go right back inside. As soon as I get back inside, I hear ta-tink, ta-tink. I hear something in the dryer. So I open it up. It is my spare set of car keys that also has a remote control, thus setting off the alarm, turning on the lights, and opening the trunk. What a normal, rational person would do in this scenario is nothing. Not this asshole from the Midwest. I owe a gentleman an apology, and he's going to hear it. So I go storming outside. The guy that I was just yelling at now sees that I have a huge smile on my face, and I'm jogging towards him. Thus sending him, and then he starts backing up gingerly, like kind of like what? Because he thinks, who's this bipolar maniac that was just yelling 1 second ago? So he starts walking. I'm like, oh no! So I start running towards him. Thus sending this 70-year-old Mexican man, this poor fellow, down an icy sidewalk running away from me. He falls and slips on the ice. I want to help him up. He's like, no, no, no. I'm like, I just wanted to let him know that I am an asshole, but I think he got that message. I think he got that. Well, when I first moved to New York City, though, one of the first shows I hosted, you got to host like you guys, this is a fucking cool show, but it's awesome. Like you do, like you do so many random different shows. I used to host a show in a basement of a hostel in Manhattan, and the only thing we would get like free tourist stuff. Like we would get free tickets to Madame Tussauds at Celebrity Wet, like whenever you want. I took like 8 girls to fucking Madame Tussauds. It's the dumbest shit. If you've ever been to the Madame Tussauds though, in New York City. The first section there is historical figures. That is the first section. And before you go in, they have a tour guide to get you excited, to pump you up. She's like, are you guys ready to have some fun? And everyone's like, yeah, all right, cool. Let's have some fun. And then you walk in, historical figures, and the first statue is Hitler. It's like, yeah, clearly this is going to be fun. We could just party around him, I guess. But then, like, 10, like, I do give him credit because he was, like, off in a corner by himself. Like, there's, like, him, then 10 feet of nothing, then the next closest statue was civil rights hero Rosa Parks. It's kind of like they put him in a wax timeout. Like, you think about what you did before you joined the other statues. You get it. But the thing, it's a tourist attraction, so if you've ever been, I don't know if you guys know, I'm sure you have one in Niagara Falls, but it's a tourist trap, so people, when they go in, first thing they want is a picture with a statue. So everyone wants a picture like Bill Clinton or Abe Lincoln, but it's way too congested over there to get uninterrupted photographs with just you and one statue. So one of the options for that is just to go off to the side for people, and people just take a picture with Hitler. But you can Google image wax Hitler. 7 out of 10 pictures is someone with a wax Hitler at a Madame Tussauds. 3 of them, because I've been telling this joke for about 2 years, now my face. So the parents are, all right. So back to the joke. I'm fucking high. I'm sorry if I fucked up this. On that note, they're like, you know, he's high. We got to fucking. But here's what, all right. Here's some. Yeah, dude, I fucking. I forget. I'm too high to remember where the fuck I am. All right. Back to my fucking joke. We're at Madame Tussauds. Fucking, we got historical figures over here. And we got Hitler over here. I think it's awkward that people are taking pictures with a wax Hitler. So here's what I think Madame Tussauds should do to prevent that from happening. I think if you're going to have Hitler and then Rosa Parks, the only way to pull that off, to go between them, that's where, next to Hitler, you got to put someone. I say, if you're going to have them, that's where you put Mel Gibson, right there. That's where Mel Gibson goes. Then next to Mel Gibson, then you could put Danny Glover. And then you could put Rosa Parks, like that. See, like the only way to transition from Hitler to Rosa Parks is if you put the Lethal Weapon duo in the middle of that. And then that's not offensive to anybody. And this joke was supposed to be so much smoother. And, like, if you did that, you just have to put those 4 statues by the side, because those would be the only 4 statues anyone would talk about. They'd be like, what the fuck is this? The new A-Team? All right, I love you guys. I think I'm done. I feel bad because I'm high and I fucked up that last story. Fuck it. All right, one last one then. All right, I'm going to tell. Oh. This will be my last story. This is relevant. Huh? How the pastries? Dude, I'm. What am I doing? Pasty? That means dry mouth. Oh, yes, dry mouth is a word I would. Yeah, fuck it. I'm with you, man. Pasties. Pasties, I'm in. My favorite rapper is from fucking Toronto, K-Non. Nobody cares. You guys are like, I don't know. I like K-Non. Fucking email me, Ray DeVito. I will listen to you. Inform me. All right. This is my last story. This is this is relevant because this girl just came back into my life. So here's what's okay. First date I ever went on, I was 14 years old. Show you how old I am. It was the weekend Ghostbusters 2 opened. That's a long, Bobby Brown was in the movie. Got to take control. We got. You know what I'm talking about? I love, like, he used to have the Gumby hair. Bobby Brown was also in the movie. He had a Gumby haircut. I was a big fan. I had one of those. You know Gumby haircut? No, he's the Gumby haircut, real big on one side, short on the other. I used to have that, man. I was into Bob Brown. I did. I had hair steps, too. That's a razors on the side. Had those. Yeah. I was chubby, so I looked like a fat Vanilla Ice running around my neighborhood. That's what I used to look like. I would get called wigger all the time. I don't know. I don't like that word. I think it sounds a little racist. I know. It's silly. Whatever. I'm high. Who gives a shit? This is 14-year-old me. Sarah Henson's going on a date with me. She's 16 years old. She's in my sister's class. She says to my mom, how come I had to wait till I was 16 to go on a date? He gets to go now. My mom goes, well, he needs a social life. It's like, whatever, I can go. I don't give a shit. Show up for this movie an hour early, and I brought flowers because I am a gentleman. And I'm standing out in front of this theater waiting for this girl for an hour. And kids that I went to school with are walking by, like, what you got the flowers for, man? I'm like, I'm on a date with Sarah Henson. They're like, really? That you dating? I'm like, yeah, that's my girlfriend. It's like, when you start dating her, it starts as soon as she gets here. That's when we hit go on that. She never shows. Never shows up. So I'm like an asshole. I run in the theater. Maybe she got here super early. I'm looking around my dumb flowers. I don't see her. So I got to get rid of these flowers. I don't want to throw them away. A kid's going to see them, put two and two together. So I'm like, I'll just leave them in the theater. I do that. Some old lady grabs them, runs in the lobby after me. Sir, you forgot these. I'm like, oh, no. I got them for a girl. She didn't show up. And the lady goes, well, you should give them to your mother. I'm like, no, that's a horrible idea. She already thinks I'm a loser. I go, you seem nice. You should keep them. She's like, I don't want them. Puts them on the counter. She's like, shit. So I go next door to the Burger King, and again, I didn't want to just throw them away. So I go in the bathroom, and I start taking trash out of the garbage, and I bury these flowers. Like, I was burying my dignity, just getting it down there, throwing wrappers on. And the whole time in my head, I'm like, this is dating. Dating sucks. I could have stayed home, played video games, not felt this shitty about myself. One day, there'll be websites. People pay money for this. I had a lot of foresight as a child. But here's the deal. I look back at it now, like spending $20 for a date, one of the better date nights of my life, but that's... But the reason why I bring it up, the reason why it's relevant, that girl, Sarah Henson, Facebook friend requested me. I know it's a long joke. Did you think it's a long... I know. We're almost at the end. She Facebook friend requested me. She is married, but you know what her job is? She is the restaurant manager of that exact same fucking Burger King. Holy shit, karma does exist, and it's in a trash can in Cleveland, Ohio. First thing I wanted to say when I said that, I saw that, I was like, oh, would you go in the bathroom? Get your flowers, bitch. That's what I want to say. All right, I'm Ray DeVito. That's it for me. Good night.
Ray fucking DeVito, everybody. Keep it going for your headliner, everybody, all the way from New York City. Wicked to have you here by way of Cleveland, Ohio, of course.
Ray's on a show called Guy Code on MTV, so check that up online. Also, he's got a show this Friday at the Underground Comedy Cafe, which is another 420 venue on Queen Street at Queen and Broadview. They're doing a comedy festival there all weekend that Ray's a part of, so go on down there Friday night and check that out as well. And yeah, we do this show every Wednesday. I'm hosting every Thursday, Hunter Collins. Every Sunday is our open mic. You can come by and get on stage with host Mike Rita. And one more time, can you guys give it up for our Vapor Central staff and all the comedians you guys saw tonight? Give them a big round of applause. I'm Justin Bieber. Good night, everybody.